Hi everyone, I'm Mark Thurston, CEO of HS2, bringing you our latest update on the delivery of HS2 from our Curzon Street site here in Birmingham at the heart of the high-speed rail network here in the West Midlands. As some of you may already know, after 6.5 years leading HS2 Limited and the programme, I recently announced that I will be leaving the organisation. So this will be my last HS2 update video. We had just received Royal Assent for phase one at the beginning of 2017 when I arrived. And I'm immensely proud of what we've delivered in my time as Chief Exec leading the programme since. We're now over 3 years into our main construction works programme, and today HS2 is supporting almost 30,000 jobs around the UK, including close to 1,300 apprenticeships. Construction of the first phase of HS2 is at its height, with major works taking place on several hundred sites across the route between London and here in the West Midlands. The next 18 to 24 months will see us move into an exciting new stage of the programme as the project increases its focus on the design and the delivery of the railway systems, including signalling, track and power, and that will transform the structures into the operational railway that future passengers will use. And we're ensuring that we have a skilled team in place to lead this fantastic programme through what will be another defining period for HS2. As always, there has been huge progress across the programme over the last 3 months since our last project update in June. In the West Midlands, throughout the summer, our construction team successfully moved 3 bridges into place, which will allow HS2 trains to pass beneath existing railway lines in Warwickshire. These incredible operations are the culmination of years of careful planning, design and innovative engineering, and in close collaboration with our colleagues from Network Rail, to complete the work safely, within planned closures, and in some cases even early, which minimise the impact to passengers and to local communities. We closed out this summer with the removal of a 4,000 tonne road bridge over the M42, and this will make the space for us to build a new structure which will carry the HS2 railway over the motorway. What was really pleasing is the work was completed safely, efficiently and sooner than anticipated, which meant the motorway could be reopened 14 hours ahead of schedule. Our new super hub Old Oak Common Station in West London, which will be the largest newly built railway station in the UK, has been recognised as outstanding for its environmental design. That means that Old Oak Common joins HS2's interchange station in the West Midlands in achieving an outstanding rating, a level of performance met only by 1% of new buildings globally. Our fleet of high-speed trains, which will be designed and built right here in the UK across 3 factories, have been recognised as the most environmentally friendly in the world. Due to start rolling off the production line around 2027, the 8-carriage trains, which will measure 200 metres in length, will be more aerodynamic, more energy efficient, lighter, leaner and greener than any other high-speed train in design, production or operation in the world today. Earlier this summer, we announced that our London logistics hub in Willesden has now transported over 1 million tonnes of spoil, taking 110,000 lorry movements off the local roads. Over the course of the project, this facility will transfer and transport over 5 million tonnes of spoil via rail from London to where spoil will then be reused. Also in West London, our 2 tunnel boring machines, Sushila and Caroline, have each completed over 1 mile of their journeys towards the capital. In July, we began production of over 83,000 concrete tunnel segments at a new facility at Hartlepool Docks. This has created over 100 jobs, including 6 new apprenticeships, and has meant that local people are able to start new careers working at HS2. Florence and Cecilia, our tunnelling machines digging HS2's longest tunnel, have made it more than 3/4 of the way through their 10-mile drive under the Chiltern Hills in Buckinghamshire. Also in Buckinghamshire, our 3rd conveyor system on the project is now in use, again removing spoil from construction. This will remove around 70,000 lorry journeys off of local roads, significantly reducing disruption for local residents during the construction. And here in the West Midlands, our 6th tunnelling machine, Mary-Ann, is progressing well on her drive towards Birmingham, and the team is busy preparing to assemble the 2nd machine, which will dig the 2nd bore of that tunnel next year. Leading this organisation and the programme has been the highlight of my career and a privilege from the very first day. The engineering challenge of HS2 is immense, and everyone involved can be extremely proud of the progress we've made, completing important archaeological and enabling works along large parts of the route, mobilising our construction partners and building the crucial new infrastructure. We've seen nothing on this scale in living memory. Finally, let's not forget that HS2 is a national endeavour a project that is transforming the economy of our country and whose benefits will be felt for generations to come. I look forward to seeing this once-in-a-lifetime project being delivered, and I wish everyone involved the very best and every success for the future. Thanks very much.